What's going on, guys? It's Leon here. For those of you guys who don't know me, I love music and I'm just a listener, a free listener. And you guys, you know, I'm just trying to make a channel specifically for music because I can't be consistent if it's not on one thing, and I want to be consistent on one thing. And so here it is. One, I'm making music reviews, so you guys subscribe, putting you guys on specifically. You're going to be listening to music and, you know, chilling together, you know, lighting some up, and you guys subscribe. So if you guys like lighting up, then like, subscribe, and join me on the music because I'm putting on. You know, I know about music. I love music in all genres and all generations and all years. But, you know, anyways, besides that, let me get back on to the point. We are talking about Travis Scott today. And yeah, bad news for Travis Scott. You know, I went to Rolling Loud in Miami. You know, he's around here. I didn't pay for it. We'll get into that another time. I just got in there, you know. And we're talking about Travis Scott and his concert up in Atsroworld in Houston, Texas. Very huge. Looked like Ultra, if you guys know what Ultra is. Very huge setting, very set up. And it was very odd of the things. I've seen a lot of videos. I've researched. I've seen. Because, like, I like Travis Scott. I like his music. And don't we all? But, you know, in reality, you can't always, you know, trust what you see. And you got to know the person for real. Because if you don't know the person for real, then you don't really know him. As an artist, I guess I respect him. But as anything else, I don't know him. So, in this video, I'm gonna be talking about this song, Escape Plan. This is his song. It came out, I think, a day before his concert. Very odd shirt that, you know, IG posts that were very odd. Him demon, like little troll eyes. And this song, though, even though it makes me dance, it's like, this is bad. And I'm pretty sure this is why everyone went crazy. The song, the music, they make you just want to dance, go crazy. But the lyrics is not good. I researched them. You guys should too. She's talking about that girl that was up in the stage. I've seen a video. She was screaming for her life. He seems to be talking about her. He's not a rapper. He's more than that. Because you guys made him more than that. I'm sorry to dance to this, but it's just controlling me. It's the freaking music. It's the production. You see, that's the truth. You know, he said something about his chain being, people wanting to snatch his chain. It could be a metaphor, something like an example of people wanting his chain or touch him so bad or see him so bad and get up close so bad to just touch his chain or something, or be famous, or be somehow acknowledged because everyone had their phone out. Everyone. That's what all kids do now in college. Just phones out. I don't know how they do it. They just keep it up. And they, no matter what happens, they keep it up. And they watching everything. You know, they just video everything. And it's like, this is what, like, happens. You know, people try to get up to the front. And, you know, we'll get into that. You know, people get up to the front. And, you know, people really want to see him so bad. You know, they don't stay in the back. I go to the front to dance. I don't go because of the celebrity. It's cool, but, you know, I'm pretty sure the fans are in the front. on everyone's a fan. Everybody wants to be famous. Open gates, man. She feeling anxious to be out where it's dangerous. Yeah, because I was anxious and rolling out. I was like, holy shit, bro. Am I going to die here? Am I going to die? Like, do I have to accept shit? I wonder what my family's doing right now. Shit, man. I should have never came here. Fuck. I'm going to survive, though. That's what I told myself. Honestly, at the end of the day, it comes to that. I told myself when I was enrolling out, and I've seen Travis Scott, he's a closer, and I just told myself, hey, honestly, I'm very physically fit. I trained all year, and then I came into that, and I messed up my ankle, and I still wanted to, like, jump in the middle, in the front, where people were being squeezed. I still did it, because I'm a crazy loon, but... You know, other people, for younger kids, I mean, you know, they're not used to things like that. And, you know, all they want to do is hold their phone up. And that's not, you know, that's not part of what Travis wants, especially as an artist that's trying to be based off of rock and takes off of rock concerts and riots and rages and stuff like that. You know, they're based off of rock, but I've never seen Slipknot or anyone, you know, people get hurt. I've heard people get hurt in Metallica, I heard, possibly in Russia, you know, but it be for other reasons. It's never for the band itself, but, you know, these are people who like did it on their own. Now that there's kids involved, there's no one to blame. The kids aren't gonna take the blame. No blame for themselves. They have, I mean, if you didn't see the beginning of the tour of the concert, people, kids broke down the thingy, you know, millions, like at least a couple hundred passed by. And they all wanted to go see Travis. I mean, they all passed through security. And, I mean... I understand wanting to see an artist, but that was, that was extreme. Like, I don't care. It's fine. You know, pass and do all this, but... Now... Talking on Travis, he's just weird, man. I can't say anything about it. He's just weird. Yeah, and I understand he's immature too. It doesn't go as much as he's being used as a tool. And you know, you have to be stupid to know that you're not being used by a tool. And he's pretty like immature. Travis is pretty immature and young. And he's just like going into a big stardom that people have made him up to be, and that's a big thing to accept, a big thing to either go on the dark or good path. And I guess he's chose the dark side. He likes rock, he likes this, he likes that, he likes rages, and people, you know what he likes seeing as an artist. And when you get so big, you start forgetting about the fans. And you just want to see rage. Well, like he said, you just want to see chaos. You just want to see, you know, you want to see your shows be the greatest. And I'm pretty sure Travis Scott performs very well. But he does not seem to, you know, I don't know what that was about. He doesn't seem to worry, I guess. Like, in my perspective, possibly, maybe I'm wrong. He saw it as someone just fainting, because most people faint in rock concerts, and I'm pretty sure he knows that, and he thinks that's cool. As a young guy, he thinks, okay, yeah, because he did ask for them help, and then he started singing, yeah, that's pretty weird, but, you know, he probably thought that, okay, he just fainted, everyone's just okay. This is what concerts bring, is you being hot and fainting, and there's just so much people, you know what you're doing, you're getting into. I guess, you know, these kids didn't care about whether or not they you know, they're overcrowded or not. Like, I mean, I understand. This thing was terrible. It was just terrible, guys. It was terrible, and that's what I think. I think Travis Scott just thinks that it was cool to have everyone do moshes and this like that because that's part of the rock culture, and he thinks his concerts are better that way. I didn't think he acknowledged that someone was dead. I thought he thought it was just fainting and people would faint. But that is still a sick thing. It's still weird. All the things he had on, like the shirt thingy with the people going into becoming demons and the portals and the Instagram where I looking on the top. That is scary. I don't think I'd go to that. That is scary. I didn't even see all of that. Travis Scott with the ears, the goblin ears and the teeth and the things that he's saying on a newspaper. Like, he knew everything beforehand with the song. It's just weird. It's just weird. But you guys, comment, you know, like, subscribe. I'll be talking more about music. This is just, I studied, I watched all of it, and it's just so weird. So sad, too. Like, condolences to the family. Like, oh my god, it's the saddest thing. Like, you wouldn't expect kids to die in a concert, you know. I mean, who let kids, 10-year-olds, go to a concert? Why was a 10-year-old there? I don't know, but I don't want to be mad at that. I just don't understand. Many reasons I don't understand. Like, I don't understand why. And, like, I can make it to a comparison to an old Travis Scott concert here when Rolling Loud. Like, and it's not, it can't just be him. It has to be half blame on the crowd, half blame on the artist. Because he takes half blame of whatever weird stuff he does and enjoys and doesn't take responsibility for. And the kids should take responsibility for their own actions and how they, you know, control themselves inside of a crowd. Because, like, I've been in there, and these kids do not understand. These kids don't care. They'll trample on you. And I know back then in the moshes, I think even in rock and EDM, everyone helps themselves. If someone's falling down, we pick them up. I don't know what goes on about in these big old rap concerts, but they don't help themselves. They don't help anyone. They help themselves. I'm ready. Like, I'm thinking, like, yo, everyone here is trying to kill me. Like, no one here wants to help me if I die. So I started to think, I'm sorry, but it's the strongest, you know, the strongest should survive. The strongest, last of the fittest. I forget, what's that phrase? The final, the fittest. Just, I don't fucking know. You guys comment. What's the phrase? Anyways, but yeah, this it's crazy. Cause they're all smushing me, and I'm very strong. I had to work out. I felt so bad for kids dying. Like, couldn't breathe up to like this. I had my guard. I was like this. I had space. I was very, very prepared. Like, all year, I literally had to prepare a whole year of physicality for that to happen. And poor everyone else who came from New York and all this, little kids came unprepared, just like terrible, like terrible, like just dying. And I don't know how everyone had their phone up. Like, why would you do that when you're like in a crowd just to take a video? I didn't want to lose my phone. It's old, it doesn't cost them, but I didn't want to lose my phone. I didn't. And I seen kids drop their phone, get smashed, their phones on the floor just get smashed because they wanted to keep their arms up. Even they were sardines, they kept their arms up. I don't know why, but they wanted to catch the, even if they're just looking at the sky, they wanted to catch that last video. I have no idea why, but I found two phones and I returned them to whoever they were after the show, because I'm enjoying myself. But after the show, I returned them. They're happy. I'm glad, because, you know, these are little kids and they shouldn't be lost with their phones in the bullshit. I would feel terrible to be somewhere in another state with my phone lost. Terrible. This is my hometown, so This is my hometown. I was in the coop. I was chilling and longboarding to my cars. Everything is beautiful to me, like a beautiful time to me. But it was that the only thing that kind of had me thinking like that was terrible. Like, because I honestly started contemplating, am I gonna die here? Like, is this really gonna happen? Am I not gonna be able to breed here? Like, nah, I'm not. My mentality had to be like, no, I'm not dying here. I'm sorry, survival of the fittest, that's the word. If I have to, I'm going to survive here. I'm not gonna die. I'm not for anyone, because all of you guys are selfish people. I'm not gonna die. I'm gonna do some type, I'm a crowd surf. I don't care. I'm going to survive. I'm sorry, but it was terrible. I did in Trippy Red, Mosh Pit, even because Trippy Red wanted the same thing. Every artist nowadays wants the same thing, the same culture, wants the same rock thing, wants the same mosh pits, wants everyone to go chaotic, and they think that's what makes a show. But if it's not controlled with, like, certain age kids, I think they don't know what they're doing, and they're just hitting each other, trying to kill each other to get to the front, because there's so much different age groups doing so many different things trying to do in the front, and it just gets full, and it's terrible. You got little girls dying. You seen a little girl on Trippy Red, like in the crowd, while Trippy was in the crowd just relaxing, and everyone was trying to get to him. Because everyone was trying to get to him and reach for his chain and all this and that, and which they did. They trampled a whole bunch of people, which were on the floor. I thought they were mosh pitting, but it was just like five people on the floor. Five people just gathered all on top of each other, like, and there's just one girl who had pop, 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 like five people on top of her, and she was in the bottom, and she looked dead at me, and I looked at her like, damn. She looked at me and she said, help me. Like, she was like, those are her last words. Like, she was dying. I was like, yo, of course I wouldn't live that down. So I had to help her. Just seeing that. So even though it was hard, I was already like trying to survive my own self. It was like everyone had to survive on your own. If you don't, crowd will take you down. You'd go under and get walked on, because these kids are terrible. I'm telling you, these kids are terrible. So what I did is, I wrestle, so I said, okay, I do this, let me help this girl, let me put my skills to test. And I told her to wrap her arms around me. She was very in the very bottom. I told her to get out, and she couldn't. She screamed. So I used my lower back muscles. I couldn't use my legs, because if I used my legs, I'd lose the traction of where I was and fall into the pit. Like, I'd fall onto them, or I'd fall behind. I couldn't lose my grip, so I'd have to keep my stance, and I just used my lower back. And oh my gosh, I got the worst cramp ever. I picked her up as just really fast, explosion. That's what wrestling is about. You got to do it quick. And I did, whew, really fast. She stood up. I just grabbed her up, grabbed her super fast. And she went up while she was grabbing my neck. And then, what she told me? She said, my phone, I need my phone. And I'm like, oh my gosh, get out of here. I told her to get out of here. I'm like, what the? You were almost dead. Like, what is wrong with you, girl? Like, your phone. Get out of here. And then, like, my lower back was cramping up. I couldn't breathe. I used the last bit of the energy I could to save her life. And I went to the freaking front. I stumbled to the front. I swam to the front. I didn't give a damn who was there. I swam. And when I got there, oh my gosh, I started gagging because I was throwing up. I was like, I can't breathe. Thank God that I did that with no substance, because if it was substance, someone would have got mad. I would have had to defend myself. But no substance, people tried to help me because they saw me gag, and I had nothing in my stomach. I just, just water and Gatorade, prepared, conditioned, And I was like, And then, like, that was the first time that I ever gagged when I had to, when I was, like, in some type of cardio type of conditioning. And I was like, yo, this is past my limits, and I'm passing my limits right now. And they help everyone help me nice in the front, and then they started to get mean, but it don't matter, man. I saved that girl. I was in the front and I almost died, but I made it, you know, with my strength and God's strength and my own and like training, you know, conditioning for a year. I did it. And I know a lot of other kids were just, all of them were just focused on themselves living. It was crazy. But yeah, like I'm saying, don't blame Travis Scott. Take some responsibility, people, because, you know, that was weird what Travis Scott did. Don't go to this. I'm not saying I support him. He's weird. But all the other things that happen, you kids have to learn how to be nice to each other, you know, how to help each other. Or just not go to it, you know. Be prepared. Be physically prepared to go to these things. It's just like war. I felt like I was in war. Like, so if you're not willing to go to war, don't go to these things. Like, that's what Travis Scott likes. That's what artists like. And that's not, you know, just Travis. Even though he's weird about it, don't get me wrong. You know, he might be very, very responsible for his own actions. And you guys should be too. Security, the production, the people who made this, the place, everyone should take responsibility. But the conspiracy theories, I give it like a 20% believable, maybe 40 to 50. It's really very weird how it all links up to him. He needs to be questioned. Artists need to be questioned. Stadiums, concerts need to be questioned. Kids and adults need to be questioned. And, you know, it's all just, you know, like I'm saying, you can't go around blaming people, and that's what happens in this world, you know. I've never seen this before, but it's happened, you know, and it's probably going to continue happening, not just with Travis, though. So, you guys, because I've had this, like I said, rolling out every artist. It happened with every artist, not just Travis. It happened. It was a big concert. Rolling out was big, happened with every artist. So, I don't think it was just Travis, you know, even though he's weird and he probably likes it the most and he cultivates it, you know, but, you know, endorses and supports it, you know, and does weird sayings about it, you know. But anyways, you guys subscribe, tell me if I'm right or wrong, tell me what you think is right or wrong, you know, just tell me, you know, I'll respond. I don't mean to offend anyone. I hope everyone is good. And those kids, I'm very sorry that happened. Like, I'm very sorry, the guy who saved his girlfriend, you know, but he died. Respect, you know, true guys, you know, that's what I'm saying. Like, there's not true guys in there. It's like weaklings, and I'm sorry, a lot of messed up, selfish guys that act like girls, and girls who are just like, you know, why are you there? Like, anyways, sorry, not sorry. But I'm sorry. It's like I'm sorry for people who lost their lives, who are injured, for the parents. I'm not sorry for, you know, those, for just kids. And I'm pretty sure kids right now are saying, oh, I got a refund. Like, because they did get a refund. And I'm pretty sure they're like, oh, I'm getting a refund. Yeah, I went to the show. It was cool. I got a refund. Pretty sure a lot of kids are doing that. Tell me no. Tell me not. Tell, like, you know, correct me. I don't know. Anyways, you guys subscribe. I'll make more videos. More songs. Travis, you will get punished. Alright, later, guys.